In his first big move as Prime Minister, Chris Hipkins has announced his new lineup to make the big calls for New Zealanders. Late this afternoon, he unveiled a new minister for Auckland in the wake of the flooding and several promotions in key portfolios. Political editor Jessica Much-Mackay has the details.
When Jacinda Ardern left the building, she made space for new faces at the top. After being lobbied for days, today Chris Hipkins announcing who will fill them. His first call, not giving himself any extra portfolios. Remember, Jacinda Ardern took on child poverty.
I'm not interested in a symbolic gesture. My job as Prime Minister will be to lead the entirety of the government's programme, and that's what I intend to do.
Here are the big changes. Introducing Jan Tinetti. She's the new Minister of Education, taking over from Chris Hipkins. Former COVID-19 Minister Aisha Viral hasn't been in politics long, but gets the meaty health portfolio.
Same as being a good doctor, understanding people's needs and working systematically to meet them.
Stuart Nash is chuffed about getting the police portfolio back. Andrew Little loses health and adds defence to his intelligence portfolios. And Michael Wood becomes the new minister for Auckland, a decision cemented by the flooding at the weekend.
When Auckland succeeds, the country succeeds. I know that the last few years have been particularly tough for the city of Sails.
Auckland is home to 1.7 million people, well over a third of New Zealand's population. A huge amount of our imports and exports go through the city, and if we get this place humming, then everyone will do well right across New Zealand.
Kieran McAnulty is the new local government minister, which means he gets to deal with the hot political topic, Three Waters. Nanaia Mahuta keeps the coveted foreign affairs job and has been told to get out there.
When she took on the portfolio in the first place, she wasn't able to travel and so had other portfolio responsibilities in addition to that whilst the border was closed. The border's now fully reopened, and so I am absolutely confident that she'll be out and about representing New Zealand.
The newbies are Hutt South MP Ginny Anderson and rising star Barbara Edmonds. The former minister responsible for Kiwi Build didn't make the cut.
He was very philosophical about it. I think Phil also recognises the need for some renewal in the lineup.
And despite being a high-profile defence minister, Penny Henare loses the portfolio.
He's got another big one like ACC, so there's always a balance here.
Chris Hipkins' tight five are all familiar faces: Carmel Cipollone, Calvin Davis, Grant Robertson and Megan Woods.
New leader, same Labour, same poor results.
Yesterday's poll, though, shows voters are giving the new PM a shot.
And Jess is with us now live. Your analysis, Jess, what did you make of these calls today?
Well, look, it's not exactly a major new look for the Labour Party. Yes, they have brought in some new blood in the form of two new ministers, but they are at the bottom of Cabinet and the rest is just shuffling around. Cabinet ministers are ranked 1 through till 20. Willie Jackson and Kiritapu Allen have gone up several spots in that ranking. That is a win for them. And Andrew Little and Nanaia Mahuta have gone down several positions. So the new leader sending a signal there as well. But for some ministers, they just carry on with the jobs that they've already got. And I think that the Prime Minister will be mindful of the fact that we're only 9 months out from an election and he's really wanting to make sure he has that stability. Now today, here in this room, it was a big test for Chris Hipkins making these announcements about the Cabinet reshuffle. Tomorrow, I understand, he will be making his first big policy announcement. It will be in Auckland with Grant Robertson, the Finance Minister, and it will be around the cost of living.
And Chris Hipkins has also announced his first overseas trip. What more can you tell us about that?
So on Tuesday, Chris Hipkins will go to Canberra to meet with the Australian Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese. It's a key relationship for us and not really a big surprise that he's making that his first visit. For Chris Hipkins, it will be his first real taste on the world stage.
I'm here, Jess. Thank you very much for that.